Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the UMass Minutemen Dynasty in NCAA 13. UMass has finished their regular season at 8-4, and it is time to do some recruiting to finish up the regular season recruiting year anyway, and get ready to see where they'll be going in a potential bowl game. So we're scouting Travis Brown, who's been on our board for quite a while, but at a 61 overall, I wasn't too impressed. Well, gave him a little bit of scouting, and he's now bumped over to a 64, so maybe we'll keep an eye on him. Howard Siegel is supposed to come on a visit this week, and after looking at some scouting, I'm not so impressed. We're going to take him right off the board because we don't need anywhere near a 60 overall wide receiver. So sorry, Howard Siegel, but we're taking you off the list. So Bo Nelson, he's at the top of our list, and he is a soft commit to UMass at this point. So we're going to go pump some more points for him and hope he makes that a full commit to us. Justin Townsend, we fought the good fight, but we're losing this one here. He is a soft commit to Georgia. It looks like we are going to lose this battle as we're not even number two on the list. Marcus Calhoun, we're hoping to wrap him up. Notre Dame not too far away, but we are the number one team on his board still. Greg Vaughn, the outside linebacker, want to secure him there. Michigan State's on the trail as well as Michigan, but we're hoping that we can land him. Corey Harvey, remember, we found out he was a gem sitting under our noses all this time, and all of a sudden he's a 76 overall plus 8. Well, he's not 100% scouted yet, but we know he's close, and he's a gem. Steve Matthews, also a gem. We need that on our offensive line because they play like Swiss cheese at times, letting pass rushers through. So a guy like that could really go a long way. Okay, we're going to look at the bowl projections. Now remember, this is not official. This is what is projected. They're saying we may play in the Little Caesars Pizza Bowl against Penn State. Penn State is 6-6. Okay, it could be another Big Ten matchup. Remember, we had Michigan in the Car Care Bowl last year. Bo Nelson does commit to UMass. So the 80 overall D tackle from Apple Valley, Minnesota, is coming our way. Excited about that. He's a JUCO transfer. We won't have 4 years with him, but hey, we will take that caliber player anytime. So we're looking at championship week, and the conference championship game will be between Northern Illinois and Bowling Green. You look at the standings for the conference, both in the East and West for MAC, and UMass had the same division score, but loses out to Bowling Green. I believe we lost head-to-head to them. So Northern Illinois takes the Western Conference of the MAC there and will play in the championship game as well. So we're going to advance through the week. There's no recruiting to do here. And when we do, we're going to see who wins the Heisman. Again, it's all people who are made up players here, but I believe that would be Johnny Heisman, Johnny Manziel, maybe, for Texas A&M winning that one. I don't know if that's supposed to be him or not, but here we go, the actual bowl matchups. It's not going to be the Little Caesars Bowl. We're going to the famous Idaho Potato Bowl in Boise. We're going to play on the Smurf turf. Checking out the national championship matchup because I always like to have some reference in who's playing. It's Michigan State against Central Florida. Weird, weird game. But we wanted to check on this because Cam Slinger right there is the backup quarterback for Michigan State. A lot of you ask how he's doing. He's not playing yet. That quarterback who's a 91 overall above him, he's starting this year and another year as well. So Cam is not going to play for a while. But for UMass's sake, it is now time for the Idaho Potato Bowl, the famous Idaho Potato Bowl, that is, and we're about ready to take on Louisiana Tech in this game. You see, we are highlighting a linebacker right there, Ches Morrison, and Louisiana Tech goes all blue, hoping to maybe blend into the turf. Now, my buddy Burns, I think, informed me that there's actually a rule for Boise State against using their all-blue uniforms, so maybe this is a little bit illegal, but we're going with it anyway. UMass, on the other hand, is going to go quite a contrast and go all-white, including all-white shoes. They want to be seen and stand out on this turf here, exactly the opposite. So we'll see whose strategy in uniform pays off. when in all reality, it's really not going to make any difference whatsoever. Better team is going to win on this day. And here we go. So we get the flyover, and it is time to play some football. We've got Wes Collins handing off to Jim Mitchell. Spin move, and he's free. Out past the 30, and a good run to start the ball game for Jim Mitchell. You see, he's rushed for over 1,000 yards this season. Going to go to him again on the second play of the game, and he gets rocked. And he's not getting up very fast. As a matter of fact, I don't know if he's getting up. He gets hit and shaken up. It looks like he is grabbing for that knee area. That is not good. We'll have to watch this. Collins on third downs finds Ronnie Parker for the first down conversion. Nice play by Ronnie Parker. And he just kind of turns around and sits down there in that open space, makes the catch. If they're going to play that far off of him, they'll take the underneath stuff. We've got hip bursitis for Jim Mitchell. We're going to put Broadnax in the game for now until Mitchell's ready. And look out, Wes Collins. Remember what I said about that O-line playing like Swiss cheese at times. There it is again. And that's a guard. Boy, we need our man coming in here to fill that space because we can't have that. Third and 18 now. Collins is going to throw deep. One-on-one. Oh, my goodness. What a catch by Ronnie Parker. And his momentum takes him to the ground, or he might have scored on that play. Ronnie Parker one-on-one showing his skills. And this is quite a treat to have him out wide, both he and Ronnie Houston. So second and 10 now. Collins is going to throw over the middle. Mark and Michelle makes the catch, but he's kind of got to dive for it, giving him really no yardage. Third and 9, Wes Collins surveying the field. He's going to go over the middle, and wow, I don't know how he got that ball into Jim Mitchell, who is back on the field. He makes the catch. They're 2 yards short. They will kick a field goal and take a 3-0 lead in the ballgame. Junk Johnson is happy and optimistic on that sideline, but he is 0-2 in bowl games, so he is going to wait and see how this turns out before doing any celebrating. So here goes Louisiana Tech, and their quarterback Young is going to keep this on the option. They are very much a high-tempo team. They go no huddle. They are trying to trap UMass in formations they don't like, which was working until this play. And they bring the linebacker blitzing up the middle, and they're able to get the sack here to force fourth down and a field goal attempt. So it's a bend but don't break series for the UMass defense. Will they get the field goal on fourth and 14? It is up and it is good. We have a tie game at 3. Tech's coach is all fired up there after they tie the ball game. So here we go. First quarter almost over, and we've got a false start from UMass's offense. Somebody on the line couldn't hold their count there, and so it'll be first and 15. Going to go to a screenplay, except here comes the rush. The ball pops up in the air. Abraham picks it out of midair and walks into the end zone for a defensive touchdown. Oh, my goodness. Disaster strikes the UMass offense. That couldn't have gone any worse, and it's 6 points for Louisiana Tech. So let's see a couple replays here. Collins just trying to stay cool there, and at the last second flipped that off for the screen pass, but he got hit a little faster than anticipated. Ball pops straight in the air, and it is a touchdown for Louisiana Tech. So it's now 10-3, trying to make something better happen here. Jim Mitchell will get about 4 yards to the left-hand side. They really like to run outside to that left side when they can. Collins is going to pass to Fozell. He finds his tight end for the first time today, and that's a first down. So maybe they can move the ball now. Jim Mitchell to the left side. Nice cut inside and then back out. First down and more. Now we're moving the ball here. The Minutemen looking to punch it in and tie the game. Hand off to Jim Mitchell. Again, he's going to get about 4 yards. Second and 6. Wes Collins. Where is he going to go? Quickly to Fosell. Hits him on the outside shoulder. Makes the catch. And we got a second and 7 now inside the 20. It's Howard, the second tight end. Going to make the catch there. Going to make it third and short. So on third and 3, hand off to Jordan Broadnax. First down and more. He eludes the defense and gets into the end zone for a touchdown. Looked like he might be stopped about the 6, but he's a little sneaky, and he gets in there for the score. We're tied at 10. UMass answers on their drive. So now we go 10-10 and a pitch to Lee. He's going to spin, and he's going to get away from tackles, and he's getting downfield to about the 45-yard line. Now they're across midfield, and Young looking to throw to Cox. Makes a nice catch, and game freezes up a little bit. That'll happen from time to time. Here's a big play. They send a man in motion. Then they pitch to Seats, and he is gone to the outside. Touchdown, Louisiana Tech. Oh, my goodness. We're not going to have much defense in this game. I can already tell. This is a nicely designed play and great execution on the blocking. Look at the tight end just sticking his block forever out front there and allowing them to get into the end zone. So 17-10, Wes Collins going to air it out. Oh, my goodness, it's Ronnie Houston, and he is wide open. No one within 10 yards. Goodbye, touchdown, and he is in the end zone. So first Ronnie Parker making catches. Now we go to the other Ronnie, Ronnie Houston. And this wasn't even close. I don't know what happened with coverage there, but he was long gone. Ronnie Houston gets into the end zone and ties this ball game again. Like I said, this game is about to get crazy because there's not a whole lot of defense going on the field. So as Ronnie Houston gets the congratulatory high fives there on the sideline, you see a replay here if he's going to snag this in. And like I said, no problem getting downfield for the touchdown. So does Tech come out and answer? Well, let's see. Young sitting there in the pocket, and he throws it right to the wrong team. That's Smith again. He's had, three or four picks this year, big ones. And that is a big momentum changer in a tie ball game. Let's see right here. He steps in front of this route coming across. And there you go. Tech's first real mistake of the day. So will they take advantage? Hand off to Jim Mitchell. Here he goes. Duke moving. Oh, my goodness. He got lit up. He absolutely got destroyed and lost the ball, and that's a fumble. Unfortunately, they lose it right back, so no momentum swing right there. They hand it right back. Watch this play. Mitchell with a nice juke, but then he just gets blasted and separated from the ball. Wow, I'd be surprised if he could breathe after that hit. Must have knocked the wind out of him. So here we go with Tech. Pass from Young to Newman. That's going to be a first down. They looked like they were really solely running option, but then they started opening up the passing game in the second quarter, and it was a whole other dimension to this Tech offense. And look at him thread the needle here. Oh my goodness, that was in traffic. Couple UMass defenders convene on him, but not before he makes the great catch. This ball put exactly where it needs to be to get the touchdown, and they do indeed get it. 24-17, almost halftime. Collins has Ronnie Parker wide open, but he severely underthrows him. If he throws a lob downfield, I think he scores a touchdown, just like Ronnie Houston did, but instead he leaves this short and hanging there to be picked off. And they've given Tech some more time. They don't need a whole lot. Cox makes this catch, and he's going to get down to the 1 yard line. It's first and goal with just under 30 seconds to go. Tech up to the ball quickly, and they go all-out blitz. Well, that's not going to work because wide open there were a couple of receivers. Lee, the recipient of the touchdown, it's now 31-17. Collins is going to go deep. This one he does throw. Oh, my goodness, what an awkward hit. Oh, Houston absorbed a weird hit. Let's look at this again. This is one of the weirder plays I've seen in NCAA 13. He goes back to make a catch, which, man, if you lead him again, I think he scores. But look at this. Nice catch. And then he gets lit up and weird physics going on there. So anyway, I just had to highlight that a couple times because it was strange. Another pass. Diving. It's Fossell that makes the catch. Timeout. 8 seconds left. They're going to take one shot at the end zone here. Collins. Don't get sacked. Throws it away. Didn't really see what he wanted. Okay. Unfortunately, they'll have to bring out the field goal team and get points where they can get them. So they get them here. And it's 31-20. At the half, the 1 second left, they'll squib kick that. And now we are into the third quarter. So Young to throw. No, he's not going to get the throw. Blitzing is Powell from the linebacker spot. And the game freezes a little bit. But in the end, it'll be second and 18 after the blitz and sack. Third and 15. Now Young is going to throw. He's got good protection this time. It breaks down. He throws the ball. This is picked off by guess who? Powell. First he gets the sack. What a great drive, because then he ends it by picking this ball off. UMass's defense makes a rare stand in this game. That has not been the norm, as they've been sliced up. But they do make a play here. Maybe the momentum can change right now. 31-20. Collins hands off to Jim Mitchell to the left-hand side. Nah, he's going to get five. That's respectable, but He's looking for the big run. Third and five. Collins is going to throw. He's going to throw to Ronnie Parker. Has to come back to that ball, but he does get first down yardage and more. So let's keep this rolling. Let's get in the end zone. Collins pump fake. He's going to throw to Ronnie Parker. That was a little bit of an adjustment. They were laying off of him, so we had him run the curl route, and it worked. Here they get a man to jump. They going to go free play? Yes, sir. Collins to Fosell makes the catch. He's in the end zone. If this stands like we think it would, yes, sir. It is offsides on the defense. Decline that, and it is touchdown UMass. Pulled to 31-26. We're going to go for two to try to make it a three-point ball game. Jim Mitchell, nope, they're waiting for that play. So it is 31-26. Third quarter almost done. And we have Young out of the ball game with an injury for one quarter. Landor, his replacement, is running well himself here, though. Looks like they're not having a problem. He fools everybody, and he's off to the races. Can they stop him? Finally, at about the 12-yard line, he goes down. But, wow, that... they sold out on the running back, and he kept it. That's very efficient right there. He gets knocked out of the ballgame. We got a third-string quarterback, Evans. Blitz him, right? Oh, no. They go with the screen. Perfect timing, and they're in the end zone again. Even their third-string quarterback comes in, and everything he touches turns to gold. Look at this. Perfectly played screen. They bring the blitz. Trying to confuse a third-string quarterback into making a mistake. No, sir. He gets a touchdown pass nonetheless. It is 38-26. Collins is going to load up. He's going to go deep. The game freezes. Is the game over? No, it's going to start back up. Ronnie Parker makes a big catch. He's inside the 40 to maybe the 39. Okay, here we go. Very next play. First and 10. Collins finds Ronnie Houston wide open. It's the Ronnie show. Parker, then Houston. Touchdown. Another big play as they let Ronnie Houston loose in the secondary. Again, that ball's underthrown. Come on, Wes. Get some oomph under that pass. Leave these guys, and you'd have easy scores. Easy scores. They do get the touchdown, so can't complain too much. But you don't want to get your guys killed like he almost did with Ronnie Houston earlier. So a 38-33 ball game, and they're bringing blitz, and this time it will get to the quarterback. That's Young. The first-string quarterback is finally back into the game. Third and 13 now. He's going deep. Where did this come from? They haven't done this all ball game. They set it up perfectly, though, and Cox goes to the house for the touchdown. They've been running option. They've been running short passing game, and then when they really need it, they open it up deep. Totally surprising UMass's defense, and taking it to the house with the long touchdown pass. How maddening is this for Junk Johnson? He just can't get a handle on this Louisiana Tech offense, and they just continue to burn them for points. All right, it's 45-33, and we're running out of time. Collins, however, does see a wide-open Ronnie Parker. Again, it's underthrown. Come on, Wes Collins, you're killing us here. I know you're racking up a ton of yards, but the interceptions are killing us. The turnovers, the fumble, interception, touchdown, whatever you want to call that play. Meanwhile, Louisiana Tech having no problem running their option. It's running very well. Hand off to Lee again, and he's going to gash him to the left-hand side this time. Under 2 minutes to play now. 45-33. We need to stop. Young, I don't know what kind of defense that was. Everybody stood on the back line of the end zone and watched him catch an easy touchdown. It's Cox once again. 52-33. A minute and a half left. This ball is thrown far enough for Ronnie Parker. He's gone. If you would have done that before, we'd probably be at a tie ball game right now or be very close, but no. Oh, Wes Collins does break a record for longest NCAA pass. Yeah, okay, we know that's fake. Every time that comes up, we know that's fake. Going for two again, trying to make it an 11-point ball game, which would be a touchdown with a two-point conversion and a field goal. Forget about it. Don't need to do the math because they pick it off. It's now 52-39, and here we go with an onside kick chance. Patton is going to kick it right off a Tech player. They do get it. Wow, I really don't like – I mean, it would be nice if there was like a scramble for the ball or something. That just hits him, and he lets the other team get it. Okay, whatever. We recovered the onside kick, and you saw those gaudy numbers that Collins is putting up. We'll add some more. Ronnie Parker touchdown, right? No, they mark him down at the one. New school record for Ronnie Parker for receiving in a game. He passes none other than Victor Cruz on that list, but you see the offense, because they got spotted at the one and they cannot get in, second and goal, they try to hurry up, play action, Collins to his tight end Howard. He's stacked up at the goal line, a big hit. Time is still running, under 30 seconds. This is killing us. We got to get in. Mitchell puts the shoulder down and does get in. But oh my goodness, we needed that time to make a stop and get the ball back. We saved all three timeouts instead of using them right there. But now there's only 26 seconds left. We have to go to the onside kick. This one is fielded by Louisiana Tech. We do have three timeouts. This is going to get tricky. You got to stop him, though. The option's been good all day. Young runs into his own lineman, and that slows him down. Gets five. It'll be second and five. First timeout taken by UMass. Young is going to dangerously pitch. Oh, my goodness. That almost could have been picked off the pitch and run the other way. How would that would have been for an ending? Third and eight now. One timeout left, but we have to make the stop. Young is going to keep it. It's fourth and 11. Only 12 seconds left. Here comes a punt. Can we get a block on it? I highly doubt it, but we send punt block, and this kick is amazing. Nothing short of brilliant. Inside the five, pins UMass with hopes of one, maybe two plays to get something done. So here we go. Gonna try deep ball if the game ever stops freezing. Here we go. Throwing deep into double coverage. Nope. Ronnie Parker can't come up with it. So 2 seconds left. Gonna go Hail Mary, trips right, and hope for a miracle here. Collins is gonna take the snap. Watch the back line. You don't want to step out for safety. Throwing deep. Can someone make the play? Oh, it almost looked like he came up with a catch, but he does not. Wouldn't have mattered anyway because you're well short. Half the field short. Louisiana Tech holds on in a very wild game, and they win the famous Idaho Potato Bowl 52-46. UMass now 0-3 in bowl games under Junk Johnson. I don't know. It's a glass half full, glass half empty kind of situation. Are you happy that they've qualified for three bowl games, or is it disappointing that they've lost three? I don't know. They'll get here and win one of them sometime here. I just have a feeling. But today is not the day. Wes Collins, pretty dejected that he made too many mistakes in this game despite throwing for a lot of yards. Terrell Cox is your player of the game. And he came up big for Louisiana Tech. Wow. There were a lot of numbers going up on the offensive side, mostly chasing from behind here in this game. But Louisiana Tech wins the bowl game. And a dejected UMass crew leaves the field. Here are your stats. Wes Collins throws for 535 yards and four touchdowns, but those two interceptions plus the sack fumble, I don't know, whatever you call that, that went for a touchdown was killer. You see, Mitchell started strong, but they went away from the run game when they had to chase from behind here. He only gets 50 yards. Ronnie Parker, 7 catches for 274 yards, a school record, like I say, breaking Victor Cruz's mark set in 2008 when he had 262 yards. Wow. But it isn't a loss. So the season ends at 8-5. Definitely nothing, you know, to feel bad about, an 8-5 season, but that bowl game would have been sweet. So let's go see who won that national championship we talked about, shall we? Michigan State loses the ball game to Central Florida. National champions, Central Florida, huh? I don't know why they're valued so high in this game, but that always seems to happen, that they're right up near the top. Very strange indeed. You see, Cam Slinger did not get into this ballgame, and I don't believe he will be starting next year either, unless this quarterback happens to enter the draft early. So we got a contract extension offered Junk Johnson's way. Going to just quickly look at this. Obviously, it's a little bit stiffer as far as the goals, but I want to stay with UMass, so what do? I'm going to take this and have Junk Johnson sign on the dotted line here eventually once he looks over this contract. Yeah, I don't know. We're going to go for it. We're all in on UMass here, so we're not going to enter that coaching carousel. We're going to stay right here and build UMass football. So it is time for the offseason to start. Got to see what we can do to make this team bigger, badder, stronger for the next season, maybe even go to a new conference. Stay tuned because the off-season live stream is coming up tomorrow. We'll see you then. Later, guys.